Focus on me. Hey, how you doing? I'm coming at y'all with a first impressions tutorial something. We'll figure it out as we go. There's been a lot of hype around this eyeshadow palette. It is the Anastasia Beverly Hills Riviera palette. If you don't know the Anastasia Beverly Hills brand, it is like the cornerstone of the first makeup prestige products you may ever buy. The Modern Renaissance palette was the basic bitch palette. Like, everybody I knew who was into makeup my age had it. I just never could bring myself to spend $40 on a palette of colors that I don't think are very flattering on my skin tone. I like dark purples, but as far as like the mauves, and they just don't mesh with me. And then there was a lot of controversy with the Subculture palette, and then the Norvina palette came along, and everybody, like, it's a thing. The Sultry palette I really wanted, but it was mainly just like a smoky eye palette, and I have smoky eye palettes, so I didn't want to spend that. So then the Riviera palette came out, and the reason it's so hyped up is because it has colors in it, and everybody was begging Anastasia to do some color. I don't know. This Riviera palette I got at my local Ulta Beauty yesterday, and I want to get this video out and about. The actual palette, you can't really see that it says Riviera, but it is like the sailor kind of vibe to it, the gold, and it's got the blue. And then you open it, very classic Anastasia palette setup. Your colors, very bright. This just screams Becca Thomas. This is why I bought this palette, because all of these colors need to be on my eye right now. They finally made a palette for me, which is bright, in your face, here I am, welcome to my eyelid. Welcome to an age where Becca Thomas isn't using a Morphe palette on her channel. Wow. We've had this color. Everybody's like obsessed to use that color. I don't know why. I'm gonna be using this bad boy right here. I haven't really seen anybody play with that yellow, and I need it on my eye today. Everyday gal, you don't need these colors, okay? Go get you the Modern Renaissance palette, honey. What I really appreciate about palettes like this is that they still give you like your transition colors and your mixing colors, but then they give you your colors to work with. Okay, like to play with. So if you want to step out of the box a little bit with a palette like this, I'm going to do a pretty like not that spectacular look. It's still going to have like gold glitter, whatever. Today I will do another tutorial with this, don't you worry, because y'all know once I get a palette that I'm obsessed with, I use it for the next like 12 videos. Okay, you can do a lot with this. Like, you could do a pretty subtle eye, and then you could do like a little pop of this in the inner corner. You can go along your lower lash line, and it looks like you put in a lot of effort and that you're really creative, but really you just put like a bright color on your eye. I'm also obsessed with palettes that give me a mirror, because I don't do my makeup with my contacts in because it gets in my contact and I can't see at all without my contacts. I can see like a general shape, but that's it. So I appreciate when palettes give me a mirror, because I have to do my eyeshadow like this. So if you want to know what I think about the Anastasia Riviera palette, then keep on watching. I'm going to swatch these a little bit here. Let's start off pretty mild. I'm going to start with Yatasha. That's one right there. I do like that the names of the colors are under the shadow. It makes it easier when I'm doing stuff like this, so I don't have to constantly look up the name. Y'all know if it doesn't say it on the shadow, you don't know the name of the shadow, because I just say this color right here. I just point to it. It ain't none of y'all's business. You can figure it out from there. Ooh, she buttery. I mean, same Anastasia formula. Swatches very nicely. Now let's get some Seychelles. I'm assuming that's what that word is. I don't know anything, y'all, so I mean, I'm just like a big dummy dum-dum, so I don't know how to read. So if that's not the color, then whatever. But it's this pretty blue color here. Make sure you can see what I'm doing. Like butter. I should really look up what the names of these before I just come on the internet with some bullcrap. Whatever this word right there is don't ask me. Ooh! Woo-hoo. This one's my baby. This one is gonna be the star of the show today. I haven't seen anybody working with this bright yellow shimmer color. Probably because like we've seen it before, but everybody wants to play with this color and we've seen her before too. So show this yellow some love, y'all. It looks like sunshine. Everybody needs a little sunshine, especially here in Tennessee where it's been raining for 84 years. I almost want to use the brush that it came with just because it came with her, so I'm assuming she's like working with this. I almost never use what comes with it. I just don't see a need when I have all my brushes that I love, but whatever. Let me work with each side of this and like we can just figure it out together. Ooh, almost forgot. Y'all ain't about to catch me with no fallout, so let's put down some powder. No, ma'am, not today. You're not catching me with this bright yellow under my eyes. Mm-mm. You might catch me with a boogie, though. I gotta get that. Let me take care of that situation. We're gonna start with Cabana right here. She's just gonna kind of be like a mixing color, a transition. She's gonna, you know, be early for the party, but she's gonna also leave early. You know what I'm saying? I'm just gonna kind of swoopity whoop whoop. There in the crease, okay? I really enjoy how that applied, and I also really enjoy this brush too. Ooh, okay, I'm excited. Just warning you, there's a lot of kickback. Let me try to see if I can show you. You see all that? Do you see that kickback? It doesn't bother me. I'm not one of those people who it like, I'm like, oh my god, I'm not gonna use it because it has fun. I don't care, okay? It is a little messy. My makeup vanity is disgusting. My James Charles palette is covered in kickback because it just like sits here. It just kind of chills on my vanity while I do my makeup over it. So there's like a lot of crap on it and you can see every bit of it. So it's just not, I'm not somebody who it bothers. It's not very professional of me to do that, but I mean, whatever. Let's like smoky it out a little bit with Palm right here, right there, okay. So this is the small shadow brush from the Ulta Beauty collection. It's like a little kind of packer brush-esque and I'm going in with Palm here and I'm gonna pack it here. And since I've never really worked with these shadows on myself, I am gonna start off with a lighter hand than I normally do, just because I don't know how these are gonna act, I don't know how they're gonna react, so we're just gonna kind of figure it out. Now I'm gonna take that fluffy brush that I used on Cabana and blend it.
Cabana unana.
Packed it onto the outer corner and then I worked it up into the crease area and we just blended her on out, introduced her to the class. She's new. I'm gonna leave it subtle like that until I put the shimmer shades on and then I'll build it up later, but we're just gonna kind of leave her there for a minute. I don't want to put too much on just to put concealer over it, you know. So I'm gonna take a little bit of concealer, okay, put it on the back of my hand, and I'm gonna take a Morphe M421, and then I'm going to half cut this crease. Now we're going in with Inheritance, my baby, the one that I'm playing with today, this bright shimmery gold yellow. And I'm taking the more packed side of the Anastasia brush that they provided for me. And I'm gonna start it in the, oh! Oh my god. Oh my god. Somebody call an ambulance. Oh my god. Never have I ever. Mother, may I? Oh my god. I'm not bringing her all the way into the inner corner because we're gonna put somebody else there. But oh my god. Oh my god. It looks like a gold medallion. Let me grab before I have a heart attack. My Morphe 124 brush. It's a little packer. Packer, packer. And we're gonna do a little. Do I wanna do Yatch or Seaside? Ooh, we're gonna have to Yatch. Now we gonna pop some Yatch. Yatch. Yat, yatata, yatata. Little yachty. Right there. Right there. We're packing some more Palm, that dark brown color, in the outer corner. Deepen it up, and I'm also going to take it on the tip of this, and we're going to make this a little bit more prominent in this crease area. With the fluffy side of the Anastasia brush. Jesus Christ! Get it together! The fluffy side of the Anastasia brush, we are going to just... The fluffy side of the Anastasia brush, we are just gonna swoopity doop doop and blend it on out. Okay? If you don't see me doing it, it's not my fault. Okay? I don't know why it's getting washed out. So just doop 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 doop. I would just like to formally announce that I am the best girlfriend ever, and me supporting my man out there with this beautiful gold smoky eye while he's coaching his softball game. Oh, it's gonna be so good. Okay, I hope you're ready. I'm their secret weapon. I am their secret defense. Woo! Okay, you see me? You feel me?
I see it. I like it. I want it. I got it.
I need to act right. I'm a grown woman. So now that they're even and matched and I dusted off my baking powder, I'm gonna go underneath with Palm as well just to round out the eye. Now I'm going to take my Morphe 124 brush again and I'm gonna go in with Sails, which is their bright white color. And it's just going to be like under my inner corner right here. Into the inner corner. It just kind of brightens everything up. And then I'm going to go in with my highlighter and everything on my brow bone in my inner corner. So it just kind of like adds everything together, you know. But first, I'm going to set my face with some MAC Fix Plus real quick. Now, where'd it go? Oh. Champagne Pop highlighter, Becca Cosmetics. Nothing new. Been using this for a minute. Same Morphe 124 brush. And we're gonna pop her in the inner corner. Right here. So, regular highlighting brush. This is the B13 from Morphe. Champagne Pop. I keep the same highlighter color that I put on my cheeks on my eyes because I feel like it gives it a way more cohesive look, but that's just my opinion. What do I know? I have a whole highlighting and contouring video, so if you want to know how I'm doing this, go watch that. I'm just gonna kind of swippy swiper swiperson swipey no swiper it on and you just don't worry about me. Okay, I'm gonna add some eyeliner to this. I'm going to use my Stila Stay All Day Waterproof Liquid Eyeliner. Right now, I'm just going to do the lash line, and I'll figure out if I want to do a wing. I don't want to do an eyeshadow that looks like this. I almost don't want to do a wing because I feel like it takes away from the from the look, you know, but we'll see. We'll see how I'm feeling. We'll see if I'm feeling that frisky. That was seriously one of the most nerve-wracking things I've ever done in my life. Not doing a wing because that gives me a lot of anxiety. But I am going to take the Urban Decay 24/7 Glide-On Eye Pencil on my lower lash line right here. And I did not take it all the way into the inner corner because I do want to leave that bright. I don't want to close off my eye. But now I'm going to kind of smudge this out. How I always smudge that out is I take the brush that I used and with the same color on it that I put along my lower lash line, and I just kind of like feather-like motions, and it smudges it, and it gives it more of a smoky look than like a harsh like 2009, you know, eyeliner look. You know what I'm saying? So I'm gonna do my lashes before I put on fake lashes to see if I wanna put on fake lashes. I'm probably going to just for like the poops and giggles of the video. But my mascara is the Stila Huge Extreme Lash Mascara. I just got like a little like sample of it from somewhere, and I've been trying it and I've been loving it. So ba-da-ba-ba-ba, bitch. Like, I'm gonna put on my lower lash line and my top lashes. Okay, you know how to do that. I don't have to teach you how to put on mascara. Do it. It looks really pretty even without a lash. Because my lashes. Oh my god, my lashes are so good. Look. Whew. Do I want to add a lash? I think this concludes this tutorial. I'm going to leave the headband on because I know my hair looks busted under this. I'm going to do a couple glamour shots real quick. Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready?
Stop watching. My neck is fuzzy. Make big deposits. My gloss. It's poppin'. You like my hair? Gee, thanks. Just bought it. I see it. I like it. I want it. I got it. Yeah, I want it. I got it. I want it. I got it. I want it. I got it. I want it. I got it.
Overall thoughts. This 10 out of 10 palette. It does have 14 colors in it, but if I used 5 of the 14, that's like over a third of the colors. So I feel like I'm gonna like the rest. I will play with the rest a little bit more, and I will show you guys. I will show you how to use them on you. I can see these having the high impact, being by bang pigment for all skin types, skin tones. They blend really super well. So I didn't have to do a whole lot, which I love because I'm lazy. Thank you so much for watching my video. Thank you for taking the time out of your day to watch my video. You could be watching a lot of people that are a lot better at makeup than I am, but you are watching me and I really appreciate that. Thank you for the support. Thank you for the view. Make sure to subscribe, follow me on Instagram, all that good stuff. I will link that down below. And I feel like I'm forgetting something. Oh, mind your business.